Now let's take a look at the transaction flow, or movement of funds in a pre-authorized debit or PAD transaction. It's essentially the reverse of the direct deposit flow. A PAD is a debit pull. In this example, a biller has established an agreement with their customer to debit their account for payment for goods or services. The corporate's FI is Direct Clearer A. One of the corporate's customers banks at a branch of Direct Clearer C. Again, the transaction originates from the business. The corporate provides instructions to their bank, Direct Clearer A, to debit an account held at a branch of Direct Clearer C. The AFT transaction is validated and bundled with Direct Clearer A's other AFT transactions for Direct Clearer C and delivered via the CSN to Direct Clearer C at the scheduled time. When the FIs update their client account records, the customer will see a debit to their account in the amount arranged with their biller. So who makes the ACSS entry? In this case, Direct Clearer A is owed money from Direct Clearer C, so Direct Clearer A would make the ACSS entry against Direct Clearer C.